good afternoon, special afternoon greetings to all our listeners. This is DBS Radio. Welcome one, welcome all to the live broadcast of the state funeral of the late Mrs. Alix Boyd-Knights, former Speaker of the House of Assembly. As we speak, we are located at the St. Gerald's Cathedral Chapel to bring you the live state funeral service. With me on the broadcast, I'm pleased to announce that Mr. Ainsworth Irish will be joining me on the broadcast this afternoon. And Mr. Irish, good afternoon to you. Welcome to the broadcast of DBS Radio.
Good afternoon to you, Kiwano, and good afternoon to listeners to DBS Radio. Of course, as you said, it's a very important moment here this afternoon at the St. Gerald's Cathedral Chapel, as we await the funeral service or mass, if you will, of the late Speaker, Honorable Alix Boyd-Knight, Emerita, who passed, a profound loss on the 29th of August, 2023. And certainly, it's a state funeral being given by the government of Dominica. As you know, the Speaker served for in excess of 20 years at the Parliament of Dominica, and she was well known internationally on the international circuit in the region because she served on the Commonwealth Parliamentary Association, and she was well known. In fact, the Speaker herself, was a barrister at law, and she was a champion, I can say in short, for women and children.
Thank you, Mr. Irish, and of course I'm just going to read a few lines in a poem featured on the program for the late Alix Boyd-Knight. It goes like this: a lamb has fallen from the family tree. I keep hearing a voice that says, grieve not for me. Remember the best times, the laughter, the song, the good life I lived while I was strong. Continue my heritage. I'm counting on you. Very fitting, and I can hear Alix, saying that to us at this time as we mourn her death. As I speak, I can see all the attendees of this funeral. They are wearing some aspect of Madras, some aspect of Creole, as they were requested to do. They were asked to wear something Creole, or the women could have worn something, creative on their head, a headpiece and so on, as they call it, a fascinator, and they have followed suit. They have heard the call, heed the call, and most of them are wearing a fascinator in Madras or something Creole. Others' heads are wrapped with something Creole. And some other piece of item in Creole, just to respect the request to honor her memory. As she was very passionate about her Creole, about her culture, about her cooking, and she was really a formidable Dominican.
Oh yes, indeed. And as you speak about the headgear, the Speaker Emerita was very instrumental in having the ladies wear their hats at Parliament. And of course, she was somebody who was very creative and had the culinary arts. And certainly, Speaker Boyd-Knight Emerita, she really served Dominica, the Caribbean, and by extension, the international circuit. And today we can see quite a number of dignitaries from far and near. Quite a few ministers are here. We await the arrival of the Prime Minister as we speak. Yes. Followed by His Excellency shortly thereafter.
And as we heard the announcement, the Prime Minister, the Honorable Prime Minister Roosevelt Skerritt, and his wife, Mrs. Skerritt, has just entered and will now find the seat. And everyone at this time in the chapel is standing. And as you said, Mr. Irish, quite a bit of dignitaries here. With the legal fraternity, the members of the association, they're all represented here. Also, we have visiting dignitaries. We have the diplomatic corps, ministers past and present. We have seen ambassadors. And also, I also saw the presidential nominee, Mrs. Sylvani Burton, as well.
Yes,
present here. So we have family, we have friends, everyone there to her, members of the opposition. I'm just seeing them walking into the church, going to find the seats, and the chief of police is here.
Mm-hmm. And of course, we have the two judges from the court, mm-hmm. Justice Williams, and of course, the ladyship is also here.
We are also expecting the arrival of His Excellency Charles Savre.
Yes, indeed.
A president of the Commonwealth of Dominica, and of course, followed by Mrs. Savre.
Yes, and it's a very solemn moment. As you know, the speaker already served very well in the parliament in excess of 2 decades, 20 years. And I can tell you, I recall the Prime Minister of Dominica did move a motion in parliament to have get that accolade of emeritus. And that was seconded by Honorable Ian Douglas at the time. I notice he's here, Ambassador Douglas, who is the ambassador to Cuba. Mm-hmm. And as we speak,
sake of our listeners, for those who are not aware of what this accolade means, the accolade of Emerita, does it signify?
Well, that signifies that somebody who have really served in a distinguished position, having given that accolade, because you know she really served beyond the call of measure. The speaker was no nonsense person. You know, her service was actually unvarnished or unscathed, if you will. And certainly that sort of accolade was given to her by the Prime Minister, who moved that motion in recognition of the service that she gave to the country. Okay. And of course, of that high level and esteem, she was given that sort of accolade. So that is the reason.
Means. Okay. Yes, all right. Basically. Thank you so much for that. And I think we have gotten a signal that we are getting ready to go on to the altar and just announced the arrival of the President of Dominica, Mr. His Excellency Charles Savre.
Yes, indeed. And the announcement was made by her grandson, mm-hmm. Philip Rowe, the Deputy Speaker.
That's
and
correct.
As we speak, His Excellency is just coming.
We will remain standing for the national anthem.
And we are going to remain standing for the national anthem of the Commonwealth of Dominica. Members moved from their seats to the back of the church, where they will accompany the casket and for the entrance hymn right here at the St. Gerald's Chapel in Roseau. And
if you look at the order of service, of course, we just have the national anthem as we indicated, the entrance hymn, which is the Canticle of the Sun, and of course, the then the second reading. And as we skip, the bell has just gone. That indicates that the commencement of the proceedings here at the St. Gerald's Cathedral Chapel. Mm-hmm. John will be doing the homily. And of course, we expect Monsignor Eustace Thomas to be here for the gospel accommodation.
Okay. Well, yeah, and as we know, just a reminder that today has been declared a national, a day of national mourning, and all flags have been flown at half staff on all public buildings in Dominica. So we're getting ready right now for the entrance hymn, as the family members and very close friends will accompany the casket down to the altar. Once again, good afternoon to all those tuned into us, near and far. Welcome to the airwaves of DBS Radio. We are also live on Facebook. We are also live on the Government of Information Service. And we want to say welcome once again to all our viewers and listeners of this state funeral of the late Emerita Alix Boyd-Knights. And thank you so much. So we have the members of the government all in attendance. And as you can see, if you can explain to them what is going on right now.
Yes, well, actually, the casket was draped with the national flag. It's now being folded by the pallbearers, and that would indicate that the body is about to be brought into the chapel itself after the initial prayer, and the proceedings for the order of service for the state funeral will commence. And certainly, this is a really signal honor here, as you know, the speaker served for in excess of, you know, 2 decades in the Dominica Parliament, and she got that sort of international sort of accolade by her service, the standards, and she stood as a champion for women and children.
Mm-hmm. I mean, and just for something that we may not have mentioned in the past, since her death, she enjoyed life.
Yes,
just by looking at a collage of photos in the program. Have you seen the one where she was riding a camel?
Oh yes.
So she traveled the world.
That might have been in Abu Dhabi.
That's right. So in Abu Dhabi,
yes.
And she rode a camel, and she loved
Father.
Cooking. And she enjoyed
life.
Son,
and of the
we
Holy
now go over
Spirit.
To the church for
the grace and peace of God our Father, and
yes,
the Lord
correct.
Jesus Christ be with you. Praise be God the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all consolations. He comforts us in all our afflictions, and thus enables us to comfort those who are in trouble with the same consolation we have received from him. I bless the body of our sister Eileen Alix Boyd with holy water that we call her baptism. Now, which St. Paul writes, all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death. By baptism into his death, we were buried together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might have a new life. For if we have been united with him by likeness to his death, so shall we be united with him by likeness to his resurrection. On the day of our sister baptism, she put on Christ. In the day of Christ's coming, may she be clothed with glory.
We join in singing our entrance song.
My dear friends, good afternoon. Could you please be seated? It's with pain that we welcome you to the funeral service of a dear friend, Emerita. I called her Emerita. So welcome, family members of the late former Speaker of the House of Assembly and Speaker Emerita of the Commonwealth of Dominica, Honorable Alix Boyd-Knights. She's among us, very much alive in heaven. Your Excellency, Charles Savarin, President of the Commonwealth of Dominica and Mrs. Savarin, Honorable Roosevelt Skerritt, Doctor, Prime Minister of the Commonwealth of Dominica and Mrs. Skerritt, Honorable Joseph Isaac, Speaker of the House of Assembly, Honorable Brigid Anicet George, Speaker of the House of Representatives of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, Your Ladyship, Justice Jacqueline Josiah Graham, Your Lordship, Justice Colleen Williams, Your Excellency, Eliot Williams, former President of the Commonwealth of Dominica, and Mrs. Williams, Honorable Members of Cabinet and Spouses, Your Excellencies, Members of the Diplomatic and Consular Corps and Spouses, Honorable Jessima Paul Victor, Leader of the Parliamentary Opposition, and Mr. Victor, all the Honorable Members of Parliament, all the visiting dignitaries, Your Worship, the Mayor, Sandra Ermine Royer, Ms. Karine Prevost, Secretary to the Cabinet, Permanent Secretaries, Members of the Legal Profession, all the official mourners, people of Dominica, members of the media. I also thank and welcome Deacon Paul, Father Cuffy, and Father Branca John, the one I baptized. He calls me Father. I don't call him son. But the question is he the one to come? I would like to extend condolences to on the part of our dear friend Father Charles Martin, who is not well, but doing better. So for all of us, my dear friends, despite the heat, better days are not only coming, better days are already here. Could you please stand? Let us pray. O God, who art merciful sinners, and the happiness of your sins, give, we pray, to your servant Alix, for whom today we perform the fraternal offices of burial. Share with your chosen ones in the blessedness you gave, so that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bonds of mortality, she may come before your face through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Job. I know that my Redeemer lives. Job answered and said, "Oh, would that my words were written down, would that they were inscribed in a record that with an iron chisel and with lead, they were cut in the rock forever. But as for me, I know that my vindicator lives, and that he will at last stand forth upon the dust, whom I myself shall see, my own eyes, not another's, shall behold him. And from my flesh I shall see God. My inmost being is consumed with longing. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, chapter 8, verses 31 to 35 and 37 to 39. If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, rather, was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or the sword? No. In all these things, we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus spoke this parable to his disciples. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them, but the wise brought flasks of oil with the lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight, there was a cry, "Behold, the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish ones said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they were off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, Lord, Lord, open the door for us. But he said in reply, Amen, amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour. The Gospel of the Lord.
When a family member or a close friend dies, whether or not the person lived a long life, we feel a deep sense of loss. Something is missing. And if that family member or friend had a larger-than-life personality akin to Alex's, the loss is even more intensely felt. For some time, it will be a challenge to enter the home. It will be difficult to enter the home and to see her favorite spot empty. Sunday lunches will be difficult. And it is with these things in mind that I commend to you, family members, close friends, colleagues of our dear sister, the words of Jesus to Martha after Lazarus had died. And Jesus said to Martha, I am the resurrection and the life. And later down he said, if you believe, you will see the glory of God. If you believe, you will see the glory of God. What a lady. Mio fam. O fam kuwai. A strong lady. Accomplished lady. A gifted woman. Diligent. Diligent. Tough. Tough. Smart. A hard-charging lady. And we could go on and on. I heard many of the stories when I went to pick up my bottles of sorrel. Yes, whenever she made sorrel, she had to call me. Padre, your sorrel is ready. I was impressed by her determination. Her determination to learn and to acquire skills in order to be independent. She was an independent lady. She did not waste time. And she was critical of anyone who wasted time. If we place her personality, her personality is important. If we place her personality and her work, her life and her death next to the Word of God, there are many lessons for us. Many lessons for us. But I wish to zero in on three areas. The first one, use your platform to inspire, not to demoralize. Use your platform to inspire, not to demoralize. Two, forgive and you will be forgiven. And three, always keep before you death, judgment, heaven, and hell. Use your platform to inspire, not to demoralize. The Lord gives gifts to all people. We all have gifts from God, and his gifts are given to each of us to first glorify God. That's why he gives gifts, to glorify God and to help others to grow in holiness, to become better human beings. That's why the Lord gives us gifts. Some of us are called to guide others. We have a voice. We have a voice. We are thought leaders, influencers. We have a serious platform, the opportunity to make our ideas or beliefs known publicly. And people listen to us. People listen to us. If we have a platform, sisters, brothers, we must use it to inspire, not to demoralize people, to build up and not to break down. No, to encourage, not to discourage, to propose solutions for improvement. That is why we have a platform. As leaders of thought, we have to bear in mind that years down the road, our conversations will be analyzed. Our public pronouncements, our work will be analyzed by generations to come. People who will live long after we're gone. And the value of those pronouncements will be assessed. What are we saying now while we have that platform? When we speak, we should not speak only to satisfy our ego. No. When we speak, we shouldn't speak to satisfy today's friends and colleagues, but we must speak with future generations in mind. Our presentations, whatever comes from us, must be animated by the one who is timeless, and that is Almighty God Himself. Use your platform to inspire people. Use it for good. Use it for good. Use your platform for the kingdom of God, to glorify Him and not yourself. Robert F. Kennedy, the brother of President Kennedy, himself an accomplished lawyer, served as U.S. Attorney General from 1961 to 1964. He was killed in 1968 while running for the Democratic presidential nomination. And he once said, "Some men see things as they are and say, why? Some men see things as they are and say, why? I dream things that never were and say, why not? I dream things that never were and say, why not?" During our sister's lifetime, she fought. She fought for victims of domestic violence, victims of sexual abuse. As a lawyer, she did this. She fought for abandoned children. She fought to hold men accountable. That was her life's work. She was doing this at a time when it was not popular to do so. And she did it all the same. I dream things that never were and say, why not? Use your platform to inspire. Use your platform for good. How do we do this? By advocating against injustice. If something is wrong, say it is wrong. And make suggestions for improvement. Speak up when someone is being unfairly treated. Say something. When someone is being unfairly criticized, say something. Use your voice for people who have no voice. Use your platform for good. And as you do that, remember the words of the Lord to St. Paul in Acts chapter 18 and verse 9. He says, "Do not be afraid, but speak. And do not be silent, for I am with you. I am with you. Contribute to the common good." Oh, that common good. The common good. How she has been forgotten. Contribute to the common good. The common good really is the sum total of social conditions which allow people, either groups or individuals, to reach their fulfillment more fully and more easily. That is the common good. Very different from the common selfishness. Very different. Where we use others to get what we want. The common selfishness, at best, at worst, we destroy others to get what we desire. And that is an industry that is growing here in our nation. May the Lord deliver us from this. May the Lord deliver us from this. And help us to use our platform to inspire people, not to demoralize people, to bring them up, not bring them down. Our sister fought for this. Madam Speaker, the second area of consideration is the one we hear so much about. We hear it so much that we get tired of it. And that is, forgive and you will be forgiven. Forgive and you will be forgiven. But I want to speak to this in light of what we are celebrating today, this afternoon, now. And to be specific, Alix Boyd-Knights, her last major assignment was as Speaker of the House of Assembly. Some felt that she was not always fair and balanced. Some felt that she went too far in ensuring that no one was imputing improper motives. Some felt that she was biased against the opposition. To those who were close to her, she was a sweetheart. But throughout her life and in her work, Alix Boyd-Knights was a bulldozer. She was a bulldozer. And when you are a bulldozer, you will rub some people the wrong way. And she did, truth be told. Some people who were offended by our deceased sister's actions may feel justified in holding on to the anger. And some may say, well, she is dead now, so this is over. But is it over? Let us expand this a little more. We may have been hurt by somebody, abused by a family member or a friend, by someone, and that person has since died. We think that because the person is dead, and we will never see that person again, the matter is over. But unless we make an act of forgiveness, the matter is not over. It is not. Unless we take the step to forgive, the person might be dead, but the anger and the lack of forgiveness in our heart is still alive and well. It is not dead. Forgive. Forgive. Make the conscious, deliberate decision to release feelings of resentment and anger. Conscious, deliberate decision. Make that. We must make that decision to release those feelings of vengeance toward the person who has harmed you, the person who has offended you. The person's death does not automatically settle the matter. No. No, it doesn't. You have to make that conscious, deliberate decision to release those feelings. And unless you do, the matter is still present. You may say, but what revenge can I have now? I don't have any revenge feelings now. The person is dead. Do you find yourself secretly wishing that this person should rot in hell? If you do, it means you have not forgiven. Whoever the person is, it means you have not forgiven. It means you still desire revenge, and that is unhealthy. Matthew chapter 6, 14 to 15, the word of God says, if you forgive people their trespasses, your heavenly Father also will forgive yours. But if you do not forgive people their trespasses, neither will your Father in heaven forgive your trespasses. Just because the person is dead doesn't mean the matter is resolved. If we want forgiveness from God, we must be prepared to give it to others. That is the word of God. If we want the Lord to hear our prayer and extend mercy to us, we must be prepared to forgive others, living and deceased. If it means going to the cemetery and standing next to the grave to make the statement, do that. Do what you must for your own sins to be forgiven. Forgive, and you will be forgiven. And the third and final point, which is a summation of the first two. Keep before you always death, judgment, heaven, and hell. St. Alphonsus Liguori, the founder of the Redemptorists, wrote many things. And one of his works is titled Preparation for Death. And in that work, he says, in preparation for death, Behold a young nobleman who was called the life and soul of conversation. Where is he now? Enter into his apartment. He is no longer there. If you look for his bed, his robes, or his armor, you will find that they have passed into the hands of others. If you wish to see him, turn to the grave, where he is changed into corruption and withered bones. O God, that body, pampered with so many delicacies, clothed with so much pomp, and attended by so many servants, to what is it now reduced? O ye saints, who knew how to mortify your bodies for the love of that God, whom alone you loved on this earth, you well understood the end of all human greatness, of all earthly delights. Now your bones are honored as sacred relics and preserved in shrines of gold, and your souls are happy in the enjoyment of God, expecting the last day on which your bodies shall be made partners of your glory, as they have been partakers of your cross in this life. The true love for the body consists in treating it here with rigor and contempt, that it may be happy for eternity, and in refusing the body all pleasures which might make it miserable forever. Refuse the body all pleasures which might make it miserable forever. St. Alphonsus Liguori. Friends, it is very easy to become distracted. Very easy. And the best of us do become distracted. We do. We lose sight of the bigger picture. We lose sight of eternity. We do. It is one thing to get distracted. It is quite another thing to live a life of distraction. Another thing to become comfortable with distraction. It is a scary thing to lose sight of eternity to the point where we just don't even care about eternity. That is a scary thing. My task, our task, as members of the clergy, our task is to keep before us always eternal life, to remind us of eternal life, the life that matters more than this one, because there are everlasting consequences there. Everlasting consequences. The more people I bury, the more fearless I become about saying those things. Colloquially, I say, kiule kiupale mokedeu. Whether you want to hear or not, I will tell you. Some people get upset, and that's okay. Keep before you always the fact that one day we are going to fall asleep in death, and that we will be judged. We will be judged. You will spend eternity with God if you used your platform to do good. If you used your platform to inspire and to promote goodness, you will spend eternity with God. If you forgave others when they hurt you, you will spend eternity with God. If you live the life of prayer and service, a life of selflessness, you will spend eternity with God. If Jesus Christ, the Son of God, was truly your God and King, you will spend eternity with God. You will spend eternity away from God if you didn't do those things. If you chose to live for yourself, if you chose to live life only for yourself, you will spend eternal life with yourself. We get what we worked for. God doesn't send anyone to heaven or hell. God doesn't do that. If we spend our life choosing good, choosing God, we receive God as reward. It is called heaven. If we spend our life choosing evil, choosing selfishness, choosing yourself, then you receive that as a reward. It is called hell. God wants us with him. He wants us with him. That is why he sent his son to die. He did not spare his own son. That's what St. Paul tells us. He did not spare his own son. He died so that you and I would have a chance to live forever. Some say that God is not fair. We heard this in yesterday's gospel text. That God is not fair. How can a good God allow people to spend eternal life in damnation? This is not fair. Oh, but he is fair. He is fair. He gives us time. He gives us the word. He gives us each other. He gives us opportunities to practice good. We have to but grab those opportunities with both hands. God wants us with him. And he asks us today to choose the way of God while we still can. Because death can come suddenly. Death can come suddenly. Choose the way of God while we still can. Choose the way of life. Father, may we use our platforms to inspire, to promote kingdom values, to promote what is good. Father, may we forgive those who have hurt us, no matter how deep that hurt has been, especially those who hurt us and are now dead. And may we keep the four last things, death, judgment, heaven, and hell, always before us, so that we will live lives of holiness, lives of goodness. Thank you, Father, for giving us time. Thank you for being patient with us. Do not treat us according to our sins, but help us today to turn to you and come to salvation. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. World without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead, and he sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his.
In baptism, Alix received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Our sister Alix was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the families and the friends of Alix, seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Alix. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your son's coming. Lord, in your mercy.
Lord, our God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Alix, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and all salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying,
Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Gabriel, our administrator, and all the clergy.
Remember your servant, Eileen, Alix, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you for your Son, Jesus the Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor be yours forever and ever.
Hallelujah, amen. 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 Hallelujah.
the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in all days, that by the help of your mercy we will be always free from sin and safe from all distress, ours you with the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of our church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that he should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Our Thanksgiving song was written by Mrs. Barbara Bully Thomas, and it will be sung by the choir. Adieu, mon ami.
God, that his servant Alix, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. The family come alongside the casket if so desire. Well, that's it for Emerita, but only down here.
My friends, our sister Alix has gone to her rest in the peace of Christ. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us commend her to the loving mercy of our Father and assist her with our prayers. She became God's daughter through baptism and was fed at the table of our Lord. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven, and with all the saints may she inherit the promise of eternal life. Let us also pray to the Lord for ourselves. May we mourn and be reunited one day with our sister. Together, may we meet Christ Jesus when she, with the Lord himself, is our life, shall appear in glory. I thought of singing in English, but my choir director thought, because of Alix, we should sing in Creole. So, Vini, Ede, Alix.
Vini, Ede, Alix.
Zanje Saint Bondye, vini jwen li, tapi souple vini chache Alix.
Vini chere Alix.
Ou souvwe lam ni pwesate, a papa Bondye, kwa met la vini chache Alix. Jesus kwiki yew alejwen li, se chans na ke pote ou an cher Abraham, pou prezante ya papa bontye, kwa met la, veni ede Alix. La vie éternelle, c'est ça nous qu'a souhaité. Clété, notre Seigneur, nous qu'a évité. En l'âme et bon Dieu, nous qu'a présenté dans l'amélie. Quoi mettre là, venez chercher Alix.
Oh, Father. Hallowed be thy name. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
Blessed art thou among women,
and blessed is the fruit of thy womb.
Lord, save your people.
Lord, save your people.
By your coming as a man.
Lord, save your people.
By your birth.
Lord, save your people.
By your baptism and a fasting. By your sufferings and cross.
Lord, save your people.
By your death and burial.
Lord, save your people.
By your rising to new life.
Lord, save your people.
By your return in glory to the Father. By your gift of the Holy Spirit.
Lord, save your people.
By your coming again in glory.
Lord,
Father, into your hands we commend our sister and friend Alix. We are confident that with all who have died in Christ, she'll be raised to life on the last day, and live with Christ forever. We thank you for all the blessings you gave her in this life, to show your fatherly care for all of us, and the fellowship which is ours with the saints in Jesus Christ. Lord, hear our prayer. Welcome Alix to paradise, and help us to comfort each other with assurance of our faith, until we all meet with Christ, to be with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. May she rest in peace. May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Alix, may the choir of angels welcome you, where Lazarus is for no longer. May you have eternal rest. I want to thank Emerita in a very special way for her friendship. I thank her for deliverance today. I was only being the main celebrant, and my son offered a beautiful homily, beautiful homily. I suppose you remember, platform. And I'm most certain that Emerita is smiling. She say, Padre, had you preached that sermon today, tomorrow you'd be on another platform. Let us pray the Lord and vow ourselves with her to our country.
Thank you. This is DBS Radio, and you're listening to the live state funeral of the late Speaker Emerita Eileen Alix Boyd-Knights, born on December 28th, 1944, to August 29th, 2023. The funeral mass at Our Lady of St. Gerard's Cathedral Chapel, Monday, September 25th. And we were here for the mass from 3 o'clock, and we're now getting ready for interment at the Roseau Catholic Cemetery. The mass has ended. DBS Radio, it was a pleasure, and in collaboration with other platforms, the GIS, the Government Information Service, we were live on the Facebook page, and we're live on radio and other social media platforms who were following, and the viewers and listeners. We want to thank you so much for staying tuned and following this proceedings here of the state funeral for the late Mrs. Alix Boyd-Knight, former Speaker of the House of Assembly. We were joined by Mr. Ensworth Irish, who joined me on the broadcast earlier on, and we want to say thank you to him for that. So once again, just letting you know that we have come to the end of the mass at the St. Gerard's Cathedral Chapel of the longest serving speaker in Dominica's history. She served from April 2000 to February 2020. She was the chairperson of the Commonwealth Women Parliamentarians of the Commonwealth Parliamentary Association from 2010 to 2013. An attorney by profession, and we saw the Bar Association well represented here this afternoon. And as you're hearing the beautiful voices of the joint choir, the Cicero singers and the choir of the cathedral coming together with their beautiful voices, singing songs of praise as we get ready for the interment at the Catholic Cemetery, Roseau Catholic Cemetery. It was a pleasure bringing you this wonderful, this beautiful mass for the late Alix Boyd-Knight. And as we proceed to the graveside, and we would like you to join us as we continue bringing you the visuals for that. Stay tuned to DBS Radio on all various platforms for the continuation of the state funeral as we proceed to the Roseau Catholic Cemetery. It was a pleasure bringing this to you, and that's where I leave you. My name is Kewana Fontaine Wilson. On behalf of Mr. Enzo Irish, who joined us earlier on, I'm taking you back to Mass. Well, we continue with the burial as we proceed to the cemetery. Stay tuned to our various platforms as we continue viewing the proceedings.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, by the 3 days you lay in the tomb, you made holy the graves of all who believe in you. And even though their bodies lie in the earth, they trust that they, like you, will rise again. Give our sister peaceful rest in this grave, until that day when you, the resurrection and the life, will raise her up in glory. Then may she see the light of your presence. O Lord Jesus, we ask this of you in the kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray for our sister to our Lord Jesus, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even if he dies. And every living person who puts his faith in me will never suffer eternal death. Our response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, you wept at the death of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You raise the dead to life. Give our sister eternal life. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our sister to the joys of heaven. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our sister was washed clean in baptism and anointed with the oil of salvation. Give her fellowship with all your saints. We ask this in faith. She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of our sister. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We ask this in faith.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Lord Jesus, our Redeemer, you willingly gave yourself up to death, so that all people might be saved and pass from death into new life. Listen to our prayers. Look with love on your people who mourn and pray for their dead sister. Lord Jesus, you alone are holy and compassionate. Forgive her her sins. By dying, you opened the gates of life for those who believe in you. Do not let our sister be parted from you, but by your glorious power, give her light, joy, and peace in heaven, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
Amen.
May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
Since Almighty God has called our sister Alix from this life to himself, we commit her body to the earth from which it was made.
Remember, you are dust, and the dust shall return.
Christ was the first to rise from the dead. And we know that he will raise up our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. We commend our sister to the Lord. May the Lord receive her into his peace and raise up her body on the last day. Amen.
In your heart. another mountain, another mile, another journey, but not much time, another road to travel, another mile, another journey, Lord, but not much time. Ooh. Son to the living, you made him Lord over all. You promised us that we shall rise with him, but only if we were his God. Another mountain, another climb, another journey, but not much.
Rest. our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those who are most in need of thy mercy.
Eternal rest grant unto Alix, the Lord.
And let the perpetual shine of her on her, make she rest in peace. Amen.
Her soul and the soul of all the faithful departed,
put a moment of our rest in peace. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Glory in the peace of Jesus Christ.
Thanks be to God. When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever
it up.
Thank you.